Now a fishing legend in his own mind, Rick Jordan.
Well, this year has not been legendary for the Jordan family. More on that as we get going. Good morning. Welcome to the Frenzy, KDAL. Russ Francisco kicks things off. Good morning, Russell.
Good morning. How are you?
Beautiful day. Lovely time to go fishing. I suppose you have to close down your store tomorrow for a little bit.
No, we keep running.
Yeah.
We're on the upper side. Yeah, we're on the upper side, so people figure out how to get to us. It's pretty good. Actually, I always tell people we sell between half and three quarters of what we normally sell on a regular routine day.
Yeah.
But last year, we sold as much as we would sell any Saturday. People just had figured out how to come from above, and they, you know, when you come in on the freeway, if you're coming from Wisconsin or something, they force you up onto 2nd Street or 4th Street, and then just come down to 15th. So people know how to do it. So we stay pretty busy.
In fact, you're just a little bit below the very first roundabout that I ever saw in the United States.
Yeah, we're a block west of it, and yeah, it's they've been there forever, and they planted a bunch of plants in there a couple of years ago. We bought the plants to plant in there, so they're still gardening it and stuff like that. So it's sort of interesting. Yeah,
what is that road? That street
is roundabout.
Jefferson.
It's Jefferson, right?
Yeah. I remember seeing that. I thought, whoa, how does this work? Now I've really got the hang of it because I have to go through one every day.
Yep. That thing has been there forever.
How about
you
that?
So, yeah.
Well, cool. What have you heard about fishing, Russ?
Fishing's good. You know, just about every place you go, they're showing us pictures of crappies and trout and inland trout. And so fishing overall has been fine. You know, you just got to hit the time to go.
I'm tempted to call my son, who I think is on the Brule this morning.
Yeah.
I think he took a canoe.
Yeah, a lot of people. I had a fellow buy a canoe the other day. He came up and said, I want to buy that canoe. I said, okay, where are you going? He says, going to the Brule. I said, oh, when are you going? He says, now.
Okay. Put a license on it, please.
Yep, well, Wisconsin's got a little different rules, so they don't have to license near as much stuff as we do.
I had a guy tell me once that your license was only good in your state. And I thought, no, I don't think so.
No.
It's good all over North America.
Yeah, as long as it's licensed, some states require them, some states don't, you know. Where you run into snags is where if you leave your boat in a state for more than 6 months, a lot of states require you to license that state or pay the sales tax in that state. So that's the one you got to watch a little bit of. But.
Yeah, that sounds like the people that play sunbirds down in Florida and Texas and Louisiana then.
Yeah.
They have to be careful. Well, what else is new? What's going off the shelves? What's the hot item this year? Items.
Well, everything is really going well. It's rod and reels are exceptionally busy this year. I mean, exceptionally, all over the country. So we're not running out, but we're getting that huge inventory down to where it belongs. And last year we carried a little bit over. Electronics is a little bit slower, but that has to do with the fact that there's not a lot of new boats selling, and people aren't selling their used boats. So it's there's a little less boat sales going on, but I've seen in the last couple of weeks that's picking up.
Mm.
People are starting to, you know, trade boats or something like that, so people fix them up. So we're a little busy at that this week. But rods and reels across the country, saltwater, freshwater, people are buying new rods and reels. And so we bought a bunch, and that was a good thing. We've had combos for $10. I mean, there's a lot of inventory piled up at manufacturers, and they're making deals. So we had combos for $10. They're normally like $25. I got to load this coming in this morning. These are $49 combos. I think we're going to sell them for like $20. And it's just all kinds of deals out there. So when we find them, we grab them and bring them in so people can get going. Otherwise, like the traditional ones where you buy a Fenwick ride, you get a reel at no charge. They're still doing that. Last year for that, they said a couple of months ago, they made the announcement. And I've been holding them on it. And just I keep calling them. And I said, did you change your mind on that yet? And they said, you can quit calling because we're not going to do it next year. I said, okay, very good. So that was almost a decade they were doing that, and they decided not to do it. And then there's, it was a good year for waders and things. A lot of people, when we finally go stream fishing, a lot of people went. Now it's headgear, anything that deters a mosquito. That's the big thing now. It's crazy. So it's mosquitoes have really been brutal this year. So that's been busy. And so we've got the Spartan mosquito deterrent things. You hang in a tree and they'll wipe out the mosquitoes, eradicate the mosquitoes in a square acre. And so that works pretty good. And so we've had to buy those several times. And so we got a couple cases of those in the other day.
Wow. I would hang one of those in my boat.
No, the idea is to hang it away from your boat.
Oh.
But I will tell you that if you have a problem in a boat with flies and stuff, get a thermocell. I had a gal lives up the street here, and she does. She's still going to school, and she was doing her homework outside, and she was getting hit alive, and she was complaining. And somebody said, "Why don't you try this thermocell?" She put this thermocell in the middle of her table, and she sat there and did her homework for a whole day. I mean, it's amazing. That thing will keep like 15 feet around you in a circle, and no mosquitoes.
Does it burn? Do you light it?
Yeah. Well, there's some that you light. No, we got the ones you plug in to a USB and charge them up, and then take them out. So that's the new ones now. So that's pretty cool. And they look almost like a vase, you know. And you just set them on the table. So those are a lot of fun. A lot of rain gear was going out the door. Now that it's not raining very much, I just talked to AFCO yesterday, and they said rain gear sales are down about 30-40%. But he said that's because there's a drought all over the country.
Yeah.
So they're not selling much of that, but we still have all the 20% off on that. Life jackets are selling really good. We've got, I think, 20 of those inflatable life vests, automatic inflatables for $79.99. We brought them in for Father's Day. When they're gone, and the new price will be like $119. So, so we can't buy them cheap enough to sell them for $79 anymore. So, so that's the thing. And then some odd stuff happened. Some of the prices actually some companies have announced a 5% price increase, and we expected prices to go down, or at least stay the same, but some companies were so upside down during the pandemic, they took another 5% price increase, and then other ones took a 5% decrease. So you just don't know what's going to happen. But prices are pretty much stable now, so we don't have to worry about, you know, things bouncing all over the place. And so that's good. Rapala let us run a sale for Father's Day, buy three, get one free. And so that's kept us busy. And so just things like that. There's all kinds of neat deals, and I just keep buying them and passing them on to people. And they don't last very long because they're really good deals. So.
Interesting. Very interesting.
Yeah.
Your hours at Marine General?
9 to 6 Monday through Saturday, 9 to 3 on Sunday, MarineGeneral.com all the time. If you have any questions, you're outside there, use the 800 number. It's 800-777-8557. We ship every day.
Attaboy. He's Russ Francisco. Got a minute here. I'm going to talk about, if I can read this. I don't have my glasses.
Uh-oh.
We'll read it when we come back. It's about
right.
The state parks around the United States or national parks. Do you know how many national parks are in Minnesota? Don't answer.
Okay, I won't.
Just think about it.
I don't
think
know
Think of
anyway.
All the national parks that you know in the great state of Minnesota, and we'll be back to talk about them.
I'm Tim Lesmeister, and this is from the pages of the Outdoor News, sponsored by Fleet Farm, serving the outdoors since 1955. So you just got that brand new sonar, and now you're seeing fish everywhere. Well, those may not be fish. I'll tell you what you're looking at, but first.
Find Dad's Day deals that won't be beat this Father's Day at Fleet Farm. This week, take 25% off select Under Armour apparel and footwear for the family. Or get a Bighorn Greystone pellet grill for just $279.99. Plus, if you find a lower price, we'll match it. We have what you need for everyday life at new, lower prices. Fleet Farm.
So many of us get that brand new sonar when we go out to our favorite lake and we're motoring around looking at the screen thinking, wow, there's fish here, there's fish there, there's fish everywhere. Those probably aren't fish. And the reason I know is because the last few years I've done a lot of underwater camera work just to make sure that what I'm looking at on the sonar is what I think it is. Many times you'll see fish on the sonar, those hooks on the sonar that look like fish, and they're not. It's something that's floating off the bottom, and it looks like fish. I've also been over grass beds where the tops of the grass is bent over. You can't see the stalk of the grass, so it doesn't show up on the sonar, but that bent head of that grass looks like a fish. It's even shaped just like that mark that you see on the face of the sonar. Sometimes rocks on the bottom look like fish. But then many times, it is fish. And when you discover what the fish look like under certain situations, wow, well then you can skip those spots that aren't fish and work those spots that are. This is from the pages of the Outdoor News.
You're listening to The Fishing Frenzy with Rick Jordan.
He isn't much in the eyes of the world. He'll never make history. No, he isn't much in the eyes of the world. But he is the world to me. My dad.
What's this guy's name?
Paul Peterson.
Paul Peterson. This is a medley of his greatest hit?
Pretty much. He was on the Donna Reed Show with Shelley Fabre. They both had hit records back in the day.
One each.
Yeah, one each.
What did Shelley Fabre do?
Johnny Angel?
Johnny Angel?
Yeah, right. Well, this is for Father's Day anyway. It's my dad.
My kids are listening.
Yeah, there you go.
Hello, son. Remember me. I'm dad. Maybe they should stop at Superior Shooter Supply.
There you go.
Pat Kukul is with us. Good morning, Pat.
And some fathers that I know are getting some mighty fine gifts from Superior Shooter Supply.
You got some last names that we could pass around?
No. They'll be all surprised. And a happy and wonderful Father's Day to everyone. It's certainly well-deserved.
Thank you. Is your dad still around?
No.
I'm sorry. Mine either.
Yeah. No. And if my father was born with more common sense than anybody, he had a fifth grade education, more common sense than anybody I have ever known in my entire life.
Now, that's good for you to say, because most kids say, my parents were so stupid.
No, my parents were not stupid. My parents were pioneers and innovators and very, very, you know, and I appreciate that, of course, more. You know, as I get older, and you see the ridiculousness of things, and he would say something, and it just made sense. Of course, not everybody would listen.
Yeah.
You know, I have to switch subjects here, and I'm just once again so proud of the high school trip. It's in Alexandria right now.
Thank you.
They're just getting done. I cannot say enough about this. They not only, of course, we have a lot of Northlanders here that are participated and did very well. Mm-hmm. 12,000 students representing 418 high school teams. So there is something in the Tribune about this morning. This is the largest event for high schoolers in the world.
This actually beats basketball and hockey combined.
It does. It does. And, you know, it's also the safest. No accidents, anything has been reported since the inception of this. It's fully compliant, male and female. And it's in what they call adaptive sport. So if you're something, you can also participate. But it's just unbelievable what they've done with this. And of course, there are scholarships available also.
Yes, yes. Do boys and girls can they be on the same teams?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Cool.
So we're just, you know, it's just great, and I just couldn't let the morning, couldn't let this go by without mentioning it. And you're probably tired of me talking about it,
nope.
But I don't care because I'm just really, really proud. And it takes a lot of work on the volunteers, the parents, on everything, and it takes a lot. So, my hat's off to everybody involved in the sports, not only in this area but nationwide. So that's wonderful. It's just great.
And these kids are not actually downing animals at this point. They're shooting at targets that fly or stationary.
Yeah. That's what they're. It's a sport, and I've always said that. That we've never regarded shooting sports as a sport. So that's why I get pretty excited about all this. So, yeah. But anyhow, back to the fathers. We have, I haven't seen a lot of gift certificates, but that's usually more last minute.
There's like, always tomorrow.
Yeah, yeah. And we've seen, I know there's going to be some happy dads out there, that's for sure. So they can think about, the nice thing about gift certificates, of course, is it's one size fits all, and you can think about what you want. So they've always been, extremely popular here.
You have long guns, you have handguns, but you also have nifty hunting equipment, things that
we do.
Warm stuff, too.
We have warm stuff because I think we're going to need warm stuff this whole summer. I was so depressed. I thought the Farmer's Almanac was going to be wrong, but I think they're going to be right. It's going to be a cool summer this summer, and that's the way it is. We can't change it. But so we don't take down our are really warm stuff. We kind of leave it out there. We take the orange down until hunting season, but not the rest of it.
Oh, I think orange is a season. No, it's a year-round color. I love orange.
It could be.
Yeah.
It could be kind of like red plaid and camel.
What's a good deal right now?
Well, we have a lot of used handguns, and we're dealing on them. We have all used guns right now, so you know we're making really good deals on our firearm inventory. That's for sure. So I'd have to say in the store, that's probably our best deal. If you're shopping for a gun, we're willing to accommodate. And we have a lot to pick from. Our ammunition supplies are real good too, and our reloading's coming back. So. But if you're in the mood for a used handgun or rifle or shotgun, come and see us.
Your Superior Shooter Supply and your address, please.
1705 Winter. We're at the corner of Ogden and Winter across from the Thirsty Pagan.
Thirsty Pagan, that's a great spot. Thank you.
It is. Okay.
All right, see you later. Bye. Have a good weekend. Dave, did you ever shoot a handgun? You were military for a while.
Not in the military, but I...
You have.
I fired a handgun. It wasn't mine, but...
What'd you shoot in the military? Rifles?
Yeah, it was usual... What do you call them? I can't even remember the name now.
Guns.
Yeah, they were standard issue in the Vietnam War era.
I don't know.
M15, M16? I think it was M16s.
I'm 4F,
that's
what do I know?
Yeah.
Remember my son was Air Force. Where did they go? Texas? San Antonio?
Yeah. Lackland.
Lackland, yeah. And they would kneel down and do the shooting, and then...
Oh, yeah, we had ready on the right, ready on the left, ready on the firing line, there we go.
Shoot!
Mine would always jam up, but...
Yeah.
That was typical.
And then, remember, my son, after he got back from basic, was comparing notes with Grandpa. Well, his was about a 20-foot-long gun that fired all the way over mountaintops...
Holy cow.
...into Italy and blah, 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 so... I kind of left the room at that point.
Mm.
But my dad was totally anti-gun.
Oh, okay.
Pro-baseball.
Yeah.
Anti-hockey. We got along okay.
All right.
All right, got to take a break. We'll see what Johnny's up to in the bait shop. Memphis information, tell me, please.
There you go, little Johnny Rivers this morning.
Is this for Johnny Chelster?
I guess that would be appropriate, yeah.
Good morning, John. Welcome back.
How you doing?
Pretty good. How was your fishing last weekend?
Fishing was great.
Oh, tell me more.
Yeah, we had a lot of lake trout. They're biting good. The northerns are biting good if you got in too shallow. And then, of course, the bugs were biting fantastic.
What did you do to keep them away?
Got out fishing in the wind.
Okay.
Then the bugs wouldn't be so bad, but if you're hanging out back at camp by the Alpines, you're going to be covered in bugs.
Jeez. Well, I don't know. I'm not a fan of mosquitoes, and I will put any goop on me to keep them away. What did you use? What did you use?
Some of that, not the musk, the other one.
DEET?
The stuff with the 40% DEET.
Yeah.
The repel.
Yeah. I bought some years ago and it says 100% DEET, which I think I heard is probably not good for you.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm afraid that this put the 100% on. I'm afraid I would end up on the ground spinning like a pony.
Growing horns. I was watching a veterinarian show on TV the other night, and the veterinarian was saying, do not use DEET on your dogs. Very bad for dogs. Yeah. Very bad.
Yeah. Yeah, I know. My uncle got a little on his dog, and the dog... started vomiting quite a bit, and he looked up on the online what to do, and quickly washed his got his dog washed up,
given
a bath, and recovered within like 20 minutes.
Ooh, but, good.
Dogs just they're like allergic to that DEET, so yeah, even a little over spraying, you don't want to do that.
Okay, very good. I'm glad the dog's okay, but I think my wife was talking about something with lemon juice or lime juice and missed it on the dog. I don't know. My dog would eat the bottle if there was, you know, a fruit in there. So how was your fishing up the way? Give us more.
Fishing was real good. But the weird thing that happened, you know, you go all the way in the boundary waters and you portage in all your minnows and everything.
Yeah.
You got in there just fine, and we had one of those big floating live wells.
Yep.
Kind of like made out of a heavy mesh.
Yep.
And I don't think we were there for more than a half an hour, and a large snapping turtle opened up our minnow container, busted it right open, and we salvaged the handful of minnows that were still left. And then I ended up right around camp. We had a bunch of wild minnows swimming around.
Yeah.
And with the smallest hook I could find, I ended up catching, angling, and I ended up catching about a dozen of nice shiners right out of the lake. And that really worked for the lake trout bait.
How about that? Well, I was in Island Lake a week or so ago, and I found a real nice yellow and white minnow bucket, you know, a troll flow or something.
Yeah, troll.
Yeah, floating around with a couple of scoops of minnows in it.
that's a pretty goldy find right there.
Yeah, yeah. I asked around, hey, anybody missing this? And nobody volunteered. I left it at the landing so somebody could take it home. But the minnows were very good. I'm sure they were from Charleston's.
Yeah, we're waiting on that bait truck today. Boy, people this last week they claimed us out. We pretty much sold out of bait, and that bait truck should be pulling in the next hour, and then we're gonna get all restocked with some fresh bait for the weekend, and should be a very busy weekend with people escaping town for the grandma's race.
Yeah, and Father's Day, get Dad out, take Dad fishing.
You bet.
Even if he has to drive and steer the boat. Okay, not just fishing at Charleston's, but archery too. Tell us about that.
Archery has been going pretty good lately. It's with so many people fishing, the range has been on the quiet side. So there's been a few people taking advantage of that and coming in and shooting in the calm and quietness of the archery range during summer. And it's a really good time of year. I think yesterday, Jay had a guy come in and he did some bow demos and ended up finding a perfect fit and went home with one. So good time of year to come in and check out the equipment and give archery a chance. It's pretty easy compared to the old Camp Miller bows.
I like how you said give archery a chance. John Lennon said give peace a chance, but archery works too. Johnny, thank you very much. We'll see you soon.
All right. Take care.
I talked about national parks. How many national parks in Minnesota? Dave, what do you think?
Well, you already told me, so I can't.
One. I guess. We are one measly park.
One national. It's just north of here.
It's a big one.
Yeah, right.
And it's very unique.
Mm-hmm.
It's called Voyageurs National Park.
Right.
And that's the one. It is the 15th most popular in the
really?
United States.
There's 14 others that are more popular than.
You could claim if you really want to, because you leave Minnesota to get to this national park called Isle Royal.
Oh, okay.
Trick question.
Gotcha.
Isle Royal to get there is...
I never could figure that out. That's what, in Michigan officially. Yeah. How they got hold of it, I have no idea.
Somebody had a bad transit.
Must have been some kind of trading going on.
A theodolite that didn't work right. Mm. But that's... anyway, the two.
All right.
I've been to both of them. In fact, last year we went to Isle Royal.
Nice.
Got to stay the night at one of the casinos up there.
Okay.
Get up early, go to the landing, get on the boat, and it's about, well, I don't know, a 45-minute boat ride out
really?
To the island. Yeah.
Okay.
And they put you on shore, and you wander around or take a tour. And then you come back and you get pneumonia. I haven't recovered from that.
Yikes.
As you can tell by the voice.
All right.
I'm going to take a break and we'll be right back. Boy, you got me here.
It's going to be Father's Day on Sunday.
Oh, my papa.
Oh, my papa.
Eddie Fisher.
Yes, indeed.
Me was so wonderful.
I'm starting to cry.
Oh, my papa.
One of the best things my dad taught me was how to play baseball.
There you go. Did he do any fishing?
No. In fact, he can't. He couldn't swim. He hated boats.
All right.
He didn't even like to walk on a dock.
Okay.
But boy, he could play baseball. He played for money when he was a younger guy.
Really? Yeah. Wow.
Kansas City, what were they called? The Blue something or others. Bluebirds.
Oh.
A big team down there. And then he dropped out of school in ninth grade.
I got you.
Bad idea.
Right.
Dave Miller's going to join us here in a second. Hi, Dave.
Hey, good morning. Good morning, Rick. Good morning, Dave. Good morning, everybody. God, what a beautiful morning, too.
Hey, we're saluting two DNR conservation officers for life-saving efforts up in the BWCA.
Wow.
Really? Yeah. I hadn't heard about that yet.
Sean Williams, stationed in Ely.
Yeah.
Back in February, they saved somebody who passed down through the ice. He and his partner, Jeremy Hinkey. So congrats to those guys for doing that.
Oh, no kidding, especially in the wintertime. Holy cow.
Boy.
Yeah. It's that takes a lot of moxie to do that kind of stuff, and those guys they win.
Yeah, well, when the conservation officers approach me, they're just looking for licenses. But you get in a conversation, they know what the fish are doing at the given lake, so that's kind of nice to talk to them.
Yeah, if they'll tell you, yeah, that's right.
We ran into a couple of conservation officers last Sunday. They were kind of hidden away in the patio of a restaurant.
Oh, probably off duty.
Yeah, they were. Yeah.
Oh, that's good. That's good. And yeah, you know, last night driving out to Iron River, I see a Department of Interior truck, brush fire truck go by and heading east. So there must be, and it was a Minnesota division truck. So must be something going on east of here. And gosh, it's like it is so dry out, and you know, even though it's green, it's incredible how dry the duff and the you know, the undergrowth is. So being careful out there is awful important. And you know, I had my first wood tick this morning or last night.
Ah!
And it brought to point a couple of things. First of all, I check every night, so I found it.
Yeah.
And secondly, I was out in the woods and I hadn't put the permethrin on my shoes and on my pants, and that little bugger snuck in and started to snack, but we got him before he had anything good. So
now that permethrin, can you put it on bear skin or is that just for clothing?
Just for clothing, really. I know there's a Picard in there.
Yeah,
I think that's how they say it. That,
yep.
That goes on skin and stuff too, but I usually just put that permethrin on my boots and on my pants and freshly washed pants. So needed a new coat.
What did you use for mosquito repellent?
And I used my right hand and then my left hand.
Good one.
Oh gosh, I didn't put anything on, and they weren't bad at first, but the little buggers kind of started coming out when the wind dropped down.
Yeah.
You know, thinking of Father's Day coming up here, and for those folks that need something kind of last minute, Northwest Outlet is a great place to do one of two things: come shopping or get a gift card, because they just love those gift cards.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind a couple of those too, you know.
Yeah. So with that coming up, and you know, it's now with Grandma's going on, of course, that's going to be a sunny day, it sounds like, so the SPF shirts and pants and hats and stuff, but it's, you know, throughout the store, it's the sandals, it's all the fishing gear, it's the camping gear. Man, we've been going through the camping gear lately, and you know, talking to all these folks that are going up to the boundaries, and now they got that partial closure going on, so I hope too many folks aren't caught up in it, but it's important to, if you've got any plans for going to the Boundary Waters, make sure you check check the Superior National Forest site.
Well, we've got some parks, campground, if you will, between here and there, even as close as Island Lake has got some places on the lake. And then you go up to just a few miles north, you got another reservoir with campsites, too.
Yep. People
Whiteface.
Are going to have some. Yeah, Whiteface, right. And, you know, it's going to be busy out there, but it's good. I am looking forward to spending a good part of the day tomorrow out helping with grandmas. And it's fun cheering those folks on and trying to make them all smile.
Attaboy. What are your hours at Northwest Outlet in Superior?
Sure. We're open Monday through Friday, 9 until 6, Saturday, 9 to 5:30. We're closed on Sundays, and folks, whatever you need for the outdoors, be it rain or shine, check us out at Northwest Outlet. Tick, check, and get those kids outside and let them have lots of fun. Thanks, everybody. Have a great weekend.
Let's go surfing now. Everybody's learning how. Come on a safari with me. Come on a safari with me. Early in the morning, we'll be
starting. Let me think the name of this crew.
Yeah. Not enough wind to have surf up anywhere at this point.
No, but boy, when we do, there's some crazy people
out
there on
indeed.
Lake Superior.
You'll see them out there in their wetsuits doing their thing.
Wow.
What's the temperature of the water?
Wow, 50.
40,
maybe.
45, 50.
Yeah.
Okay.
Water temperature on the inland lakes. What do you think, Matt King, climbing up near 70 surface?
It is. One of my guys was out on Pike Lake last night, though, throwing some lures at some docks for some bass. He said it was only 64 on the top.
Stirred up a little bit, huh?
Yeah, so that's, that's not too bad. Some of the other, the darker color lakes, they're getting up, they're around that 70-degree mark. It hasn't hurt fishing. Fishing's been good. People coming in pretty much everywhere you go. They're getting fish. They're doing well. I mean, this has been one of the best years, I'd say, is for consistent fishing.
Really?
People are coming in. They're doing well as far as everything. Walleyes and a panfish and bass and just everything. My son's been out bass fishing quite a bit. We went out the other night on Fish Lake, caught some nice ones, but he's been fishing Caribou Lake and several other different lakes, and been doing really well, him and his buddies. So that's been really good.
If I was going to fish caribou, I'd put in there at the back landing, the one on the west end, and I go out to that big lily pad, weed patch, I think was more on the east end, and I'd circle that for crappies and bass. What do you think?
Yeah, that's a good spot, and you'll catch some nice walleyes once in a while in there too. Yeah, there's some nice fish in caribou. And it hasn't, it's not quite late enough yet to get, it gets a lot of weeds in it, but it's not quite at that point yet. So fishing's good out there, though.
Yeah, what's leeches, minnows, crawlers, rapalas?
Boy, yeah.
Everything?
All of the above. and we're selling... I'll tell you what, we're going through crawlers like mad here. I went through, we fill boxes full for the weekend, when we do them, and we went through three boxes yesterday. That's a lot of crawlers. That's a lot of 2.5 dozen containers.
Wow.
Crawler bites has been pretty good. Leeches too. We've been going through a lot of leeches. But the minnows, too. I mean, it's been everything. And then, like you say, a lot of plugs for bass, too. Guys are starting to fish the bass pretty heavy, too. So,
back when I was about 16 for a birthday, my cousin, Frank, who taught me to fish, he got me a lure called a Bassarino.
Absolutely. White and red, right?
Yep. Still got
those
it.
Those are great plugs. Great plugs. I grew up too with. Did you ever see the one kind of like a Bassarino, but it was called a mouse? It was black with little yellow stripes and had a little tail on it. Wood plug.
Wow.
That one came across kind of like a Bassarino. It kind of wiggled back and forth as you came across.
Yeah.
Boy, great plugs there for bass.
Yeah. And you could pop them a little bit on the surface too.
Yeah, nothing more fun than when the water erupts, right, with a bass hitting it on the surface like that. That's a lot of fun.
Yeah, you're right. Unfortunately, it was small northern, but hey, we're catching fish.
Yeah, that's right. As long as there's something tugging on the line, it's going to be fun.
That's right. Deeper water. I'm surprised that crawlers a little bit early. And what do the fish think that crawler is?
I mean, well, I think part of it is we're a little ahead of schedule because of this weather's been so warm, right? So we're, I don't know what fish think half of this stuff is that, all the lures they make today. Yeah. I mean, there's so many different things out there that, you look at it and you go, wow, they bite it, and they do it. You know, that goes back to the old, you ever heard of guys using barn door hinges and putting hooks on those and trolling around with those things,
Yep.
Fish will, something that moves by them, and if they're hungry and it sparks their eye and it, they think it's trying to get away from them, well, they're going to go after it.
Yeah, those old buzz baits, you drag them across the surface near a weed bed. Incredible.
Yeah, right, exactly. And it's just fun getting out there, no matter what kind of fishing you're doing. And boy, there's a lot of people this week heading out. The last 2 days have been very busy. I expect today to be the same.
Mm-hmm.
So we should have a good weekend of fishing. I mean, we can't beat this weather. I'm trying to sell rain gear, and well, it's tough to sell rain gear when you haven't rained for a month and a half.
Well, it will come.
Yes, it will. But, it's good that people have been able to get out and enjoy themselves with this nice weather.
You bet. I'm trying to think of another lake that might be interesting. It'd have to be a deeper lake. Well,
Island.
St. Louis. Which one?
Island.
Well, there you go. Yeah.
No, that's got a lot of nice structure down a little deeper to start jigging those walleyes on and running. A lot of guys like to run those deep diving cranks too. Once those fish start going down, and they do well out there. I've never been a huge Island Lake fisherman. We've talked about that. I like, Boulder and Rice and stuff like that. It is a good lake. It's got a lot of fish in it, and it's got a lot of area to cover. So.
Yeah, we've been getting a lot of those small walleyes that they want taken home.
Right, right.
5, 6, 7, or 8 inches. But,
yep.
I just wish that back 120 years ago when they built that, those guys that were told to clear the land had really cleared the land. You got so many snags down at the bottom.
Right, yeah, there is a lot. All these reservoir lakes, when you flood it with timber down there, and then the timber lays down, and yeah, there's a lot of, but it creates nice structure for the fish.
That's what it's there for, I guess.
Absolutely.
Oh, you got any good deals before we say?
We do Father's Day sales going on. We got 10% off trolling motors and bait coolers, 20% off life jackets, 20% off rod and reel combos, 30% off the rain gear. So you can get that before it does start raining. And all of our firearms are on sale.
Oh.
We got up to from $50 to $75 to $100 off on every firearm in the store. So, and we're fully stocked. I'll tell you what, I can hardly fit another one in. So come on up and check it out.
All righty. We'll do it. Thank you, Matt King. See you later. Fish with care. Probably going out later this afternoon, depending on number one son. Will he come back in time? If not, we're up early tomorrow. Want to go with us, Dave?
Probably not.
Come on. Come on. Yeah, no. I'll have coffee and a little pepper-upper in there.
Now, what are you going fishing with? Have you got your live bait or your...
Oh, I got to tell you, I had a wonderful thing happen. George at Zenith Glass fixed my windshield that got damaged.
Oh.
And he worked very hard at it.
Yeah.
Got the right thing in. It really looks good, and I'm happy with that.
All right.
Good stuff.
No bugs in the teeth as you're running across the lake.
Well, the windshield was still there, but it flopped a little bit.
Oh.
And you had to lean back, otherwise your forehead was going to hit it. So be careful when you go under bridges. with a windshield.
All right.
I think Island Lake, you can go under the bridge now.
Good.
For the most part. Unless you've got a big pontoon with high gates on it.
One of the advantages of no rain, huh? Lake yeah. is coming down.
You should talk to Nora from Minnesota Power and see what her thought is on the lake level. Maybe we'll do that next week. Hey, that's a wrap. Happy Father's Day to all the dads out there and granddads.
There you go.
And you too, Strandy.
And you. All
right. Thank you.